broadcasting live. It's America's longest-running national radio talk show on computers, Computer America, hosted by national columnist Craig Crossman. Look for Craig's weekly column in your favorite newspaper. This show is being beamed nationwide at computeramerica.com. Keep it here for technology news, computer products, guest interviews, and your phone calls. You're listening to Computer America.
Hello, and welcome into the Computer America Show. It's the nation's longest-running, nationally syndicated radio talk show on computers. Computer America is heard around the world and coast to coast. And I am your host, Craig Crossman.
And I'm your co-host, Ben. Hopefully some of you were go-getters and you did your Christmas shopping on Black Friday. And that's very good in Cyber Monday. But I know a lot of us out there, and myself included, you don't get your shopping done until probably about a week beforehand. So this segment is going to be one for you guys.
Right. I mean, let's face it. What was the news story we did that online shopping has surpassed brick and mortar shopping? Yep. That was just recently. That's an amazing statement. So then it becomes a battle of different places that you can go online. I know most everybody thinks of Amazon and places like that, but there are a lot of other ones out there, including our guest, who this is from a company called GiftFind. GiftFind's mission is to literally help consumers shopping online in Canada and the U.S. to find gifts at the best possible prices, while also providing them with all the information needed to make informed purchase decisions. Find gift ideas today and compare prices on laptops, cameras, clothing, and much, much more. GiftFind is the world's largest gift site, featuring over 300 million gift ideas. Let me say that again, 300 million gift ideas for any occasion from over 500 of your favorite stores. GiftFind is committed to delivering consumers a superior online shopping experience. Joining us right now is Jason Brown, GiftFind's CEO and founder. Jason, welcome into Computer America. How are you? Jason, are you there? Well, I see him there, and I see that he's unmuted, but...
Can you hear me now?
Yeah, we hear you.
There you go.
There you go. I had the mute on my mic on. Sorry about that.
I knew that was going to happen. Don't worry about it. So many do that. They unmute themselves and they forget that their microphone is muted. Hey,
We've lost more good people to the mute switch than anything else.
Jason, how are you?
I'm good. Thanks for having me here, guys.
Yeah, our pleasure. So give us a little background about GiftFind and a little bit about yourself before we get into this.
All right, so a little background just on GiftFind for everyone who's still wondering is we're not just a shopping website. What we are is we're a price comparison website. So what we want to do is when you come to our website, you're not buying off us. We're going to send you to your favorite store with the cheapest price, but we're going to show you all your favorite stores like Amazon, Walmart, Best Buy, all on one page so you can see who has the cheapest price. And what we're also going to do is give you video reviews, product reviews, and a lot more information you need to make those proper purchase decisions.
So you're basically an aggregator, is what you're saying. GiftFind is an aggregator of all these different places.
Yeah, you got it. With our goal, like I said, just to save everyone using our site time and money.
Now, how long has GiftFind been around?
GiftFind's actually just publicly launched about this month for Christmas, so we're excited to be here. I've personally been working on the site for 3 years developing it.
So. Cutting edge. That's what we like here on the show. Now, let's face it. Now, you're not the first aggregator out there. There are another number of them out there. What makes GiftFind different than other websites that claim that we're all going to go to different places for you?
Well, that's the one thing. You see, a lot of people in the aggregation industry, a lot of them are just very aggressively looking to make money for themselves, and they're not actually looking to create product comparisons for you. So instead, what they'll do is they'll show you 5 different products in their search results, which are not the same. And what they'll do is they'll just show you 1 store for each product. They won't actually show you 5 stores selling that product. And the whole reason they're not doing that is just so they can send you off the site and make as much money as they can. We here don't believe in that. Our whole goal, like I said, is to show you 5 different products and also 10 stores for each product selling it. So we really focus on that and giving the consumer the information versus pushing them off our site and just trying to make money.
So, and how do those companies make money? So in other words, they push you off to somebody – let's say a website, let's say they push off to a Walmart website, and they say, here's the best deal, and then you buy it, then they get some of the kickback from that? I mean,
sometimes Walmart or Amazon, everyone's different, but they'll pay a little bit of a commission backwards if the company's big enough. So sometimes it incentivizes those companies to only promote a certain company and not actually fairly show the market and its participants. So we actually believe that some of the actual affiliate and aggregator sites are hurting the market for consumers, and our goal is to try and improve that.
So you're not just looking for the referral. You're actually looking to present these items that – do you feel that people are out there really looking for one item, or do you think they really do want, those 5 or 10 other relevant search topics?
Well, the way it works is we're actually just showing you the store selling it. So say you want an Xbox One console, 500 gigabytes. Mm-hmm. On our website, we would show you that product, but we would also show you the 10 stores selling it so you can pick the cheapest price. Because if it's on Amazon for $500, but say Best Buy selling it for $300, you'd be much better off going to Best Buy than to Amazon. So we try and help you with that process so you don't have to go to all the stores alone.
Now, do you have a bunch of guys sitting there late at night and doing all this price checking, or is it some sort of automation? I mean,
3 years. Sounds like he put the work in himself.
Yeah, how do you accomplish this, Jason?
So me personally, I'll tell you a little bit about me. I've been building websites since I'm 60, and I'm currently 26, so about a decade going on more now. And pretty much I got really good experience over the past 10 years building sites and different types of websites. I was also fortunate enough to go to university. I took a business degree, and my major was entrepreneurship and strategy. So I got very good insight into planning business concepts and how to scale them properly. And one of the really lucky things I was able to do is before I went to university, I worked in a third-party warehouse. And what a third-party warehouse does is they store other people's stuff in their warehouse and ship it for them. So if you own a lot of product or you're a business and has product to ship in another country, we will act as your warehouse and ship everything for you. So I was able to get a lot of in-depth research with big box stores and watch how all the different retailers and sellers work together in the big box stores. And I got a really good insight into that industry using my degree and my 10 years of experience, and I was really able to focus and create Giftfind. Now, you guys sort of asked, do I have a big team managing it and everything? And there's about 15 of us all together. I do outsource as much as I can, but the key to Giftfind is our algorithms. That's what I've been working so hard on for 3 years. So when you use our search bar, you could type in 21st birthday gift ideas, or you could type in the HP laptop you're looking for. But we will always be able to show you results, usually for what you're looking for, and do that at a much better rate than all of our competition.
So the secret sauce to Giftfind then are the algorithms that you've created. This sounds a lot like what with Facebook, what's his name? I'm blocking his name.
Zuckerberg.
Zuckerberg did. He was big with the math and the formulas, and he was trying to find these algorithms to. So you're saying that a lot of your stuff is AI.
A lot of it's algorithm-orientated. The comparison process is totally unique to us. So like I said, if you go to another aggregate site, no aggregate sites are the same. Some of them do it a lot better than others, while others are just concerned, about sending you off the website. So our main focus is to literally just provide the consumer and our users the best experience possible. We're not concerned about making money because we believe if we just do a good job at showing you the best prices and store selling it, all else would follow for us.
But just to be clear, at the end of the day, though, these people, they are leaving your site to complete their purchase.
Yeah, we do not sell anything on the website at all. So our goal is not to have you check out on our site. We are just acting as the source that you come check your price. So if you're on another site about to check out, we recommend always check our site, see if the price is cheaper, and if so, we might save you quite a bit of money. And the more you spend, the more money we're probably going to save you.
Now,
and that actually brings up an interesting point. Why did you decide to go with website? You've been doing this for 10 years. Obviously, you have a very good background in this. But why did you decide website when they have plugins for browsers or apps for smartphones? Why website?
My personal view when you look at the industry and everything is we are currently usable on a mobile device. And the internet is still the internet. The internet's the biggest thing in my mind, to date, and that's where all of e-commerce is based. So we wanted to stay within the e-commerce lines that they're in so that the customers would be familiar with the kind of portals and everything like that.
So if somebody buys something, they find I'm looking for, let's say, a TomTom navigator, and and I'm at this one place, and then I go to Gift Find, and I find, oh, I can get the TomTom Navigator cheaper at, I don't know, Walmart or some other place. And because of Gift Find, I make the decision to buy it at that merchant. Do you benefit from that? Do you have some sort of arrangement with them at the merchant?
Yeah, each merchant's different. Some people are also free. So right now what we're going to be doing for the next 6 months for anyone advertising, anyone who has their own business and selling products, is they can list their products for free on our website. And what we are going to do is we're going to send you guys traffic. You guys can make all the sales in the world, and we're not going to take any affiliation from you for the first 6 months while we're launching and growing. And this is going to help us build the database, but also, you know, just show our partners and all the other businesses using our site on how beneficial it can be. Because we only send the highest quality traffic to our partners, and that's because we filter them so good with all the reviews and information that before anyone even visits a store, you can be sure that the consumer is ready probably to buy.
So how do you get to them, Jason? I mean, you pick up the phone and call Walmart. I mean, how do you make these liaisons?
Well, it's part of the challenge in the process, right? With 500 stores, no one's, you know, working the same. So you got to learn how to bang on different doors, and you know, there's lots of various tactics I'm using to get everyone's data together and everything like that. But definitely not a challenge. Definitely not just one tactic, you know.
Mm-hmm. All right, no, you have your work cut out for you, and you, it sounds to me like you're the new kid on the block, even though you've been around for a while. GiftFind is obviously something that's brand new,
yeah.
But I would think that companies would be most receptive to you, given the day and age. I mean, when you come and you explain to what it is that you're doing, how receptive are they?
Well, you know, it's a win-win for both of us. Like we said, any company that we approach, our pitch is, how would you like free traffic with the ability that if any sale made is yours? You know, so we're not going to charge you anything unless our advertiser were to make a sale, if they were to pay us. Mm-hmm. So they have no loss in the situation except free traffic and free exposure. With the worst case, they have to make a sale and pay us a little bit of money.
Okay.
So it's win-win for them, but also for the consumer. Like I said, you know, we're not always making money off our advertisers. So the consumer is really the winner here.
So it sounds like an excellent business model. So how are you being received by the places that you're posting? I mean, how many companies are you representing so far at this point? I realize it's early in the game, but can you mention about, you know, because I think that's directly proportional to people who are going to be coming to your site. They want to know, okay, I'm getting to look at all these different places. What kind of setups do you have so far?
Yeah, of course. So what we try to focus on also is, if we're going to do price comparison, the first thing we tried to focus on was bring in everyone's favorite stores. So whether it was Amazon, Best Buy, Walmart, the Microsoft store, Dell, Panasonic, Under Armour. We focused on all the big stores and brands and made sure that we have them part of our 500 store selection. Mm-hmm. And this helps ensure that everyone, when they're comparing prices, they're already searching their favorite stores that they would have likely gone to anyways. So this is what helps, you know, save the time and save everyone money.
And you have that already in place.
Yeah, so, correct.
And that's all right. Well, no, that's great. I mean, we had, I don't know, Ben, we had, for example, like a lot of other, Kayak was on the show, you know, when they first were coming up to it, and they were just getting started.
Oh, cool.
Had the same conversation, and now look where they are today. So the point is,
look where they are, bought out by another bigger company, but
the point is, everybody has to start somewhere. It sounds to me like you're starting very strong, and I guess the way you can do that is because of two things. First of all these big stores are completely aware of how important the internet is for shopping. So you have that on your side when you knock on the door. So you already have their attention. And then when you can make a presentation like the one you just suggested, I would think that there would be little to no resistance to making these alliances. And
exactly.
And then as time continues on, you can kind of do your thing. What about now, I know a lot of the aggregators will do consumer feedback. Do you think that's important?
Yeah, of course. You know, when you're making a purchase, you want to know what other people think who have bought that before you. So if the item's horrible, you want to know it's horrible so you don't even have to buy it, right?
Mm-hmm. Right. So what do you do?
But what do we do on our site is we take it a step further. A lot of people might only provide their own user database reviews, and they'll be very slim. You won't see any from any products. But we're proud to say that pretty much every product has a review. A lot of them come from Amazon. We're also offering video reviews and our own user reviews. So you get to see everything on the product, including the specifications and all of the different sources of information available before you buy, all on one website.
Now, I know there have been some controversy. Some people were saying that individuals were really from different companies and they were seeding, you know, with really complimentary reviews, that type of thing. Do you watch that, or do you police for that, or is it too early in the game for you to do that? I mean, what's your anticipation?
Our personal review database that we control, we approve everything. So if we don't think it's correct or we think it's misleading, it will never be published in our database. That's our own monitored thing. We do a very good job of it. External sources like YouTube and Amazon or anyone else who has reviews that we might be showing you, that's under their control and not ours.
Right. But you do present it to them with the proper caveats, saying that that we can't control what's being said on these other services.
Yes, of course. It'll show right where the reviews are from and that they're not ours, so you'll know exactly the source and who is it. If it's YouTube, you'll see. If it's not us, you know.
All right. Well, you're obviously right in the thick of it, and certainly well versed in this. So I'm going to ask you this question because you're a pro at it, and so I'd like our listeners to know what your thoughts are. If you could talk a little bit about some of the common problems consumers face when shopping online.
Yeah, so one of the biggest problems when shopping online I'm finding is the actual import duties, whether it's coming from China or from the U.S. to Canada or from Canada to the U.S., people are charging duties on items that are imported into their country. And not only that, but different currencies you'll find. You might be purchasing in the euro, or you might be purchasing in a Canadian or the U.S. dollar. And if you're in another country, sometimes the currency conversion can catch up to you, plus the shipping charges, then the duty. So, yeah. You know, I call it the big three together. It's a very big problem when it comes to online shopping around the world for everyone.
And yeah, and they can accumulate so much to make the price of the item more expensive than if you bought it someplace else, I guess. And so how do you deal with that?
Well, you see, not always is that the case. Sometimes it can be so cheap in China that by the time it reaches you, even with all those extra costs, it's still cheaper than in the U.S., right?
All right.
So that's where price comparison really comes in, is online shopping's diverse, no situation's the same, no product will always be cheaper in one place. So knowing that, you need to always be comparing prices and looking for the best deal. Me personally, I've taken hours, maybe even days, looking for the best price on a specific item like drones and stuff like that.
Okay.
So, well, you know, my site really helps me there.
Incorporating drones in the delivery of your items, I don't know.
Amazon's looking into that. We don't sell anything, remember, so we're not going to be shipping anything.
What about counterfeit items? I mean, you mentioned China. I mean, there's so much of this of counterfeit going on. If I'm going to buy something, do you rely again on this on the source to watch out for that, or how do you?
On that note, when we say we have 500 stores, we're not going to let anyone into our database. We're very selective. So like I said, we started with all the big popular brands that everyone knows, whether it's Best Buy, Microsoft, Panasonic. You can guarantee they'll be in there. But when it comes to the smaller mom-and-pop shops, we really scan them to make sure they're reputable. So a lot of the China people that we have, which would be GearBest, you know, Focal Price, which are some big Chinese websites and distributors, we make sure they're scanned and they're very reputable. We won't accept just anyone, like I said.
Okay. All right. Well, that's all important, and I want our listeners to know what you do about that. So talk a little bit about some of the problems people have when searching for gifts online.
All right. So this is the best thing. Do you guys remember Facebook? You mentioned it earlier. They used to have the gift platform they introduced a year or two, maybe ago, maybe more.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And you used to only be able to give a teddy bear, a mug to someone, you know? Like, what if someone actually wanted a computer or the video game? You know, it wasn't there. So, you know, one of the biggest problems I've seen with actual gift websites in general, not just shopping websites, was they don't have what the person actually wants. They might have good suggestions, you know, but it's not what the person specifically would want, you know, for the gift.
Okay.
So for me, that was one of the things I wanted to do, is when you're on GiftFind, if you want the Xbox One console, I guarantee you the Xbox One console will be there, you know. Nobody wants to get a gift they don't want, and if we're going to buy gifts, we should make sure that any gift you would want should be available to you.
Okay. And you make those assurances?
Yeah, with 300 million products, you can pretty much be sure we have anything you would want. You know, when you go search other websites, like in Canada, for example, our database is the largest in Canada by far, so there's not another website in Canada who would offer as many products as us on one website.
Well, obviously, you're very excited about this, and it's just come online. What kind of reception is GiftFind getting, and what kind of users? Talk a little bit about the reaction of consumers toward to GiftFind.com.
You know, consumers, the one thing I find is they're so used to just shopping on one website and doing the checkout is that it's a whole new experience. They can't even believe that this kind of stuff exists and that price comparison is available. I find a lot of the market isn't educated on it, and they're not using it. So, you know, when they find out, they're very happy. They're very excited. You know, who's going to complain about me saving them time and money every time they shop online, right?
And I think, you know, it's a little bit of what you said earlier. You know, you were looking for drones and you've spent, you know, many, many hours looking for the best price from this one, this one, this one, making sure all the features are the same. But, you know, I know a lot of people that do that, but there's just not many services because, you know, other websites, they definitely don't want to redirect you to other sites that have it maybe for cheaper. They definitely want to keep you there and make you purchase it there. So it's definitely something that it's not really, you know, popular. It's the idea is good. It's just no one's really put
exactly
it out there.
Exactly. Like I said,
way.
The execution has been so weak. I think that's part of the problem. So I'm really trying to focus on for everyone. You know, if they have suggestions, they give it to us. The site's always being updated for its users to be improved like that.
Really.
Right. And so one thing that a lot of consumers, you know, sometimes they get a little bit miffed at, but, you know, you understand it's just how the internet works. How do you deal with advertising on your site? Do you perhaps, you know, put certain advertisers up front so you see them first? Or, you know, is anything kind of, you know, paid to get a better presence on your site?
No, it's my pure selection of what I think the market's doing. You know, if I think Amazon is the biggest sale, I can put their banners up. It's our team's decision internally. You can pay for sponsored spots if you would like. But currently it's a mixture of everything. You know, we're offering free listings, we're offering banner advertising, and it's also up to us to be able to choose where stuff gets to go.
I know this is a tough question because you have such a wide diversity of products. On GiftFind, Jason, but how much money can you think a person can save per purchase on GiftFind?
You know, per purchase, let's say the average purchase would be around, you know, $50, $60 per person. We're probably looking at about $20 in savings sometimes on the average. You know, if you were to say the average purchase is $100, I could say $20 would probably be the saving I would be giving you. So once you scale your shopping, you'll be able to see the money that you will really be able to save.
Now, do you keep track of that for people, or basically they have to have their own Quicken up and running at the same time, or do you keep...
Well, you know what? A lot of times people will be on another website actually, and they'll be about to check out, and that's where we say, before you check out on any website, always come to GiftFind, search for the product, check the price. You know, we're just trying to make sure the industry's fair and that nobody's, you know, taking advantage of the customers too much. You know, there's no reason in my mind an item that is the same should be $500 and $300. You know, I just don't believe that's fair. So that's our whole goal is before you buy, check our site, and our whole goal will be to show you the lowest price.
Where do you draw the line? I mean, if you've done all the work, you're about ready to check out, now you want to go check GiftFind, and GiftFind has it, but it's only like $5 left, less, or, you know, something small. Does it make sense to switch over?
You know, that's where it's totally up to the consumer itself. We like to say check us before you buy, or if you're shopping, use us to shop before you buy. It works both ways, but, you know, it's always up to the consumer. If you're looking for 5-day delivery instead of 30 days or 10 days, you know, you might have to pay a little more. So, like I said, the situation's never the same, but it's always up to the consumer. We're just trying to help provide the lowest price and the most information for you, so that you feel like you're getting a good deal also.
What if a consumer finds a lower price than what you have that you're showing on GiftFind? Do you offer them a method of letting you know that so you can adjust accordingly?
If they do, they can send us a suggestion. Maybe the store would not be in our database currently, which would be the reason, or we're just not lining it up with the item at the moment. Mm-hmm. But usually, like I said, that's not the case. Most of the time, you'll see we're very competitive and right on par with the market.
So that's right in line with how your users can help you to grow, is it?
Yeah, you know, our users, we want them to tell each other and tell their friends about this. You know, it's the best way to shop online. Like you said earlier, with the internet and online shopping just growing so much recently, It's, you know, with so much stuff out there, it's almost impossible to sift through it without an aggregate site these days.
Yeah, I would tend to agree. And of course, now we're right really in the middle of the holiday shopping. You picked a great time to come online. So
yeah,
certainly to do that. Jason, we're at the bottom of the hour. We're going to take a little break, and then we're going to come back to you, okay? So if you could stand by, we've got lots more questions. You're listening to the Computer America Show. Ben and I are talking to Jason Brown, the CEO and founder of Giftvine. It's an online aggregator of places that
price comparison.
Yeah, the comparison, so you can compare them. We're going to take a break. Another news test bulletin review from Marty Winston, a brand new one, and we'll be back with him right after this.
And yeah, we are back with Giftvine.ca or Giftvine.net. And yeah, it's a great price comparison tool that you should be using whenever you've searched for a product, because let's face it, it's the internet. It's not like the old days where you have to drive from store to store to store. You can just go to one website, type in one product, and you can find it all right there, easy to use. And, you know, let Jason Brown do all the hard work for you. You don't have to do it. But it's we're kind of going over. And yes, you come out during the holidays, and that brings up a point where how do you deal with deals? Because, you know, these things, sometimes deals, and especially close to the holidays, sometimes they happen, you know, for 24 hours only. Perhaps they happen for an entire week. How often do you update for deals? Like, are you going to show
so that's people? That's a great question. Mm-hmm. What we do with the deals and everything in general is our prices. We're updated almost live, and if not live, it'll be every 48 hours, I believe. We have systems running that are doing that for us. So we try and keep the data and all the prices always up to date, most recent. So if there's a sale, like you said, going on for a week, it'll be updated right away. We do have most of the big brands being pulled live.
Okay. Well, we have here's an email from, this is we submitted a question from one of our listeners who's listening right now, Jason. He asks the question. He says, I just did a search for an item on Giftvine, and it shows it on Amazon for $44.95. But when I clicked Visit Store, I assume that's on the Giftvine website, the lowest price is $70 plus shipping, and it is listed as a used product. What's going on?
Interesting. That's a very rare case. Like I said, usually it's pulled live, so what could have happened is because of the live situation, it could have just sold out his item, and as he went to the site, it's literally might take, you know, an hour or so to get the live update and the refresh in the cache.
Uh-huh. So does that happen often, or you're saying that's kind of a rare thing?
No, that's very, very rare. Usually all the sites for Amazon.com and .ca are pulled live, and they should be accurate there.
Okay.
But I guess, just like our listener, you're going to find out pretty quick if there is a discrepancy, because, you know, it's going to send you directly to the product page, and if it's a different price or, you know, what have you, at least there, it's going to be updated very, very quick. It's not like you're going to check out on giftvine.net and it's going to be some kind of snafu in the wiring. Like, you're going to know.
Exactly.
Okay. So talk to us a little bit about, again, since you're in the middle of all this, was in the news, Ben and I had announced that online commerce had surpassed brick and mortar shopping, yeah, which was a real landmark. What are your views on the future of e-commerce, since you're right, again, in the middle of this?
You know, it's a great question, because e-commerce, the one thing really holding it back, I find, is the shipping times and the shipping costs. Like I said, duty we can deal with, but it's really just the wait times and the shipping costs that's really a big problem in keeping any actual physical retail going. It's because sometimes people don't want to wait that long. So my views on the industry and where it's going is that if, in general, shipping can get into 24-hour, 48-hour zone, you're really going to see an explosion in the online game, because with such efficiency, being able to get anything you want at your door quickly, that should really change the consumer behavior in the market.
So you're saying delivery is delivery issues is key to the future of e-commerce, how fast people can get the product?
Of course, because like right now, let's be real, Amazon is really great, Walmart is great, but not everybody is great at getting you the product quick and cheap. So we need the whole market to sort of catch up to that, you know, because if you can sort of buy from anywhere and get your product within 48 hours, no matter where it was purchased, you've got a whole new market dynamic for consumers then.
But doesn't that cost of shipping factor in? I mean, obviously, if you're a Walmart or a large company like an Amazon, you can deal with that. But if you're a little mom and pop who have, you know, some very exclusive items that you're looking to sell, you can't compete with that kind of delivery, or can you?
No, you can. It's up to you where you're pricing. If you've got a unique item, that price should not, you know, if it's not a duplicate item that somebody else is selling,
right?
You know, you should be able to compete in the market just fine. I, for example, sell a lot of slot car race sets through my one site. It's called Race World Canada. Mm-hmm. Slot car racing, you can drive these cars around the track, a lot of fun. And, you know, just in general,
yeah,
good example of that. Going forward, the market, you know, it's drastically changing, and I have a lot of experience in logistics. And like I said, just delivery in general, because it can take a week, it can take 30 days from China. It's, you know, it hasn't totally shifted the market yet, even though it is shifting the market. But once the China delivery and delivery from other countries is really enhanced, you'll find that the whole market's really going to explode.
It hasn't exploded already?
It already has, but if you think this is explosion, right, just wait until that happens. You might even see, you know, retail, you know, just hanging on physical retail.
Well, but are you of the opinion that physical store, brick-and-mortar stores are doomed to extinction? They can't be. I mean,
no.
Stores
not,
like
not doomed. Not doomed. There'll always be a reason, you know, to go get your physical, but as the data shows, you can see the online's already overpassed it. So in 5 years, you know, the growth, if it continues online, it's really going to look like a one-way battle.
Well, what's the stuff? I mean, people, I hear stories like people will go to a Best Buy and look at the items and everything, and then they'll go back home and they'll order it on Amazon for cheaper.
We're talking about people want to be sure that they're getting the best deal, so exactly. They know that online they can check a lot of different places.
I mean, I went to a Best Buy a couple of weeks ago. I wanted to buy something, and before I went there, I went online to shop around, and I found it for like $20. This item was for $20 cheaper. I was going to Best Buy. I found it online $20 cheaper. You want to know where it was $20 cheaper, Jason? The Best Buy website.
Amazon.
No, the Best Buy website.
Oh, there you go. Amazing.
I walk into the store, and there it is for $99, and I'm at the cash register, and I took a printout, and I unfolded a sheet of paper, and I showed it to the guy. I said, you're selling this for $20 cheaper on your own website.
Not a problem. Too, right?
No, click, 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 and done. But had I not done that, I would have spent $20 more.
Yeah, you know, I'd recommend just pull your phone out, check my website when you're shopping in the stores, and you'll see we got Best Buy in there.
Now, is that just because it's an oversight? Because their IT department can't keep up with all of this? I mean, what causes things like that to happen? I mean,
there's no website. You know, physical retailing, it costs money to put the product in the store. So when the product is in the main distribution center for a Walmart, for example, it's going to cost them X amount to put that product from the main distribution center into the store, which can also help lift the product prices sometimes. So because you're ordering online, and they're able to ship out of their main warehouse, and that's able to lower their overhead.
Yeah. But they
offer you the better price.
But they always say we'll match the price no matter where it is. This happened to be at their own website, but I couldn't find any cheaper anywhere else. So then I came in and I showed them
that. Yeah, so that would just be an internal issue on their side then, you know, misgaming people.
Yeah, exactly. And you wonder how many they sell that way, and people don't know. But
yeah, you know, with so many products, you'll never know the actual error count, really. There's millions of products, so.
Is it ever going to smooth up? Is because we're dealing with humans that there are always going to be errors like that, or is automation going to make that basically go away?
It's a hybrid. You know, automation will never be automated without manual input, so it's totally a hybrid for everyone in the game. And, you know, everyone, I believe, in our goal, like I said, at GiftFind, is just to promote, you know, a fair marketplace to everyone where they can see everything and they, you know, not, they're not getting taken advantage of.
And we certainly don't like to be being taken advantage of. But
no one does.
No one does. But at the same time, you know, I guess you can't rely on, you know, them just being, when you walk into the store, you're going to see the lowest price, because that's not going to happen. You're going to, I guess it's the informed consumer is the one that's going to benefit the most.
Of course, and sometimes they'll roll the price back online, but maybe it takes them a week or two to change it in the store or vice versa, right? So
yeah.
I can cause that.
So is there like a, you know, would you say in your experience, you know, building this and curating this, would you say there's a certain point where it's like, oh, that's $5, there's really no point in looking that up online? Or would you say that almost anything that you purchase is worth looking up?
Honestly, pretty much anything is worth looking up because there's so much money to be saved. If you're going to go buy 10 $5 items, but you can save $2 on each $5 item, you know, it's still going to be worth your while. And, you know, every dollar counts for every purchase for the next, you know, 5 years that you're shopping.
Hmm. Wow.
You got to think of it like that, right? You're always purchasing, so let's try and save when we're purchasing.
Yeah, exactly.
So basically, your site is completely free to use at this point because, as you say, it's just starting out. Do you find eventually that there are going to be places where you're going to start charging as GiftFind comes more unto its own?
For the user, it's always going to be free. So for anyone shopping, it will always be free. You can create an account on our website, one of the features I haven't mentioned, and you can actually save products. So if you see something you like, or maybe it's too high right now, or you want to get it later, you can save it to your account and then go check the price, you know, every month or every 2 weeks and see if it's up or down.
So the benefit for registering at GiftFind is to keep some archival information.
Of course. You can write product reviews also. Once you're registered with the website, you'll be able to add to our database of product reviews if you have any input.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So, you know, we hope everyone's going to join in together to sort of create a great place for everyone to shop.
Any other benefits to registering at GiftFind?
Any other benefits? You can save your products. You can, like I said, watch for the cheapest price. We do have a price alert actually coming, so when you have a product saved, you can set your price for that product if it's too high, and when the product hits that price, we're going to be emailing you.
That's nice. So that's a future.
Yeah, price alert, we're going to call it.
Do other websites have that now? But it's only just for their own web. That's only just for their.
I mean, personally, I definitely know that feature from Steam, but that's not the same.
Yeah, it's out there. It's not big. Like I said, the one thing that's really good about us is because we have the product you're looking for, we can even give you a price alert. A lot of the other places aren't even going to have what you're looking for or a fair comparison. So their price alert's probably going to be biased, not ours.
Okay. So what are some of the best ways to find the best price on products, Jason?
Like I said, so when you're shopping price comparison sites, you use GiftFind in general. Great place to start. But if you've already found yourself on your favorite site and you're about to check out, you know, we always suggest visiting a price comparison site, specifically GiftFind. And, you know, make sure you see the different prices, the people selling it, read the product reviews, and, you know, make sure you're making the right purchase decision for yourself.
So if someone came to you and said, okay, why should I use GiftFind? What would you say to them? Why?
Why aren't you using GiftFind? Honestly, it would be the real question. It goes back to people not knowing what price comparison websites are. You know, once you realize I don't sell anything and I'm just trying to save you time and money, it's almost a no-brainer when you see the 500 stores I'm scanning for you.
You know, the knee-jerk reaction from consumers, when you hear somebody say, I'm not trying to sell you anything, that's when all the alert buttons go off, you know?
Yeah.
So you have to kind of get around that, don't you?
Well, that's the one thing is we don't sell anything. And like I said, once people understand what price comparison is and they'll understand that we're just a neutral player in the market, you know, we're just trying to make everything clear for everyone and act as an intermediary. We are not selling anything. We just direct you to your favorite stores.
I think Ben is on your website right now and he's looking at drones.
Yeah, I think he just found one there.
Yeah. It's funny because, I assume that you're Canadian, and the fact that the price differences between Amazon US and Amazon Canada are so drastic.
It's nuts, eh? Especially with the currency conversion going on right now. There's a lot of savings to be had for people in the US buying in Canada and also vice versa.
Really? It's good both. Yeah. It's really good in both directions. Usually one suffers. Yeah. Why is
the U.S. dollar so powerful right now that you guys actually are going to get a lot more for your dollar? So even though it might be 70 Canadian, you know, that 70 Canadian might only be 40 American, really.
So the idea is try to find the item in Canada.
Yeah, type in the search bar while you're there. Type in, GTA 5 or GoPro Hero 4. And you'll see we make good matches. Like I said, the one thing we really focus on is the more popular the product or the book or video game, the more matches you're usually going to see for that item because it's more popular. So when you find more rare items and stuff like that,
Ben, I know you do a lot of shopping on Amazon. You're actually an Amazon Prime member, so I know you do a lot of that. I know you've just been noodling around a little bit on it. Do you think that's something you might want to use yourself? I'm just kind of curiosity, Ben.
What, a Giphine?
Yeah.
Oh, of course. It really just goes back down to it. How easy is it to use? And you know, if this was convoluted and it took a while to use, and it was, you know, kind of it broke up the flow of, you know, want a product, find a product, buy a product, then it would, you know, it probably wouldn't be that attractive of a service. But it really doesn't break it up. I mean, it fits right in nicely with, you know, want a product, find a product, and it fits in right there nicely. That you can just use the service and it's not going to, you know, redirect you, take too much time. Yeah. It's you know, it's just another good service to use when shopping online.
Now, when you go to giftfind.net, it redirects you to giftfind.ca, which is Canada's...
Yeah, currently we're running .ca as our main. What we're working on actually is an international IP targeter, so that's going to redirect everyone from the U.S. to a U.S. version, a Canadian version. Mm-hmm. So right now we've built and launched the main public version, which is going to be expanding outwards into each country.
Mm-hmm. Where is that mall that I'm looking at in your homepage? It looks really slick.
I'm not sure. We change the homepage picture, you know, every other day or so. So,
yeah. I wasn't sure if that was Photoshopped or if that's an actual mall someplace.
Yeah, it's a mall somewhere, it looks like.
Yeah.
I'm not sure if you're taking requests or for features or anything like that.
Yeah, we
are. But one thing that might be a little fun with this is, this is again borrowing from the airlines, but kind of a price chart, you know, over
time.
Yeah,
price
kind
graph,
of thing.
Correct?
Price graph, yes. Yeah. Where you show, you know, how much it was 6 months ago, 3 months ago, and stuff like that. Would something like that be interesting?
Yeah, that was coming out with our price alert feature. The price graph and price alert are actually working together on the same thing.
So he seems to be on the right track.
Yeah.
So talk up a little bit. We're almost out of time. Tell us a little bit what we're going to see from GiftFind in the upcoming months ahead. What are we going
to do? You're going to see our mobile site's going to come out, so you'll be able to find us in the App Store. You can already use us on your mobile phone, so don't worry. Just go to the internet browser, giftfind.net, giftfind.ca. You can find us there. And just a lot of new features. If you keep checking in on the site, we're going to be adding new features. Like you said, the price alerts, the price graphs. We've got some conversion tools coming. So not only will we show you the different prices in the currency, but we're going to be converting that into your currency also.
So you don't have to do the calculations. It's all
exactly. We're going to take out as much work out of the process as we can for you.
Again, the service, giftfind.net or .ca, completely free. To the end users.
Completely free.
Never charge, certainly so. And again, I guess the best thing is when you're ready to click the buy, when you finally find what you want, you know, open up another tab, because you won't find it on the site that says check GiftFind, but you go up another tab and go to giftfind.net or giftfind.ca and look for the product there. And then compare.
And the search bar is the way to go. You know, whether you're typing in a general word, 21st birthday gift idea, or the specific product, that search bar is very capable at finding what you're looking for.
Yeah, exactly. Any other thoughts that you want to let our listeners know about GiftFind, Jason, before we say good afternoon to you?
No, we hope everyone's been having a good holiday season and shopping online and having fun, and we just hope we can save you some time and money. Check our site before you buy. And hopefully we'll save you a lot of money this Christmas.
And that's what it's all about, I guess, saving money. You know?
Exactly.
So you can buy even more gifts.
Yeah.
Jason, listen, it was a pleasure having you here on the show. Thank you so much for being here with us, and have a great afternoon, and best of luck to you. All right?
Thanks a lot for having me, guys. Appreciate it.
Take care. Have a good one. All right. Bye-bye.
All right. Take care.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
All right. So there you go. GiftFind. You can check it out for yourself, and certainly, I can't see anything wrong with it. I just see things that are right with this. I don't see any objections. It makes perfect sense.
Like, they're not adding a convenience fee. They're not, you know, no. Making you check out from their store instead. They're not adding another layer where they're trying to make money. They make their money clearly through referrals, mm-hmm. but. You know, at the end of the day, you know, you have to find these products some way.
Yeah, exactly. So, and I think the best thing is, you know, if you're at the checkout and you just before you hit that buy button, you know, go to giftfind.net or giftfind.ca and see if you can find a better deal. According to Jason, you have a very good chance of doing just that.